Worker bees versus drone bees. Facts: other types of bees and division of labor process. The drone bees. Drones are the male bees produced from unfertilized eggs. They neither sting nor work. Their main duty in the hive is mating with an emerging queen, and that duty is performed only once in a lifetime. As soon as they finish mating with the queen, the drones fall down and die as they have completed their destined duty. The queen also mates only once in a lifetime, but she does not die as a result. Drone bees are very few in any hive since the unfertilized eggs that produce them are scantily laid by the queen. They constitute less than 1% of the bees in a hive. The other drones, which do not participate in mating, only loiter around the hive and feed freely from the labor of the worker bees. The population of the drones in any hive is invariably determined by the queen, which lays very few big and unfertilized eggs from which the drones are produced. The worker bees. The worker bees are female bees. They are produced from smaller but fertilized eggs. It is from among them that the queen bee emerges. Division of labor. Worker bees are classified into groups for the purpose of carrying out specific duties assigned to them. Some go out every morning to scout for flower nectars with which to produce honey. Some are assigned to the duty of picking resin with which to produce propolis. Such resin is picked from certain trees at certain periods of the day. Some others are charged with fetching water to be used in the hive. All of them travel out in groups of hundreds into the wild vegetations or plantations every morning to carry out their duties. And for carrying out such duties, they are called foragers. Among the other multitudes remaining in or around the hive, some are responsible for security by guarding the hive against any foreign attack or aggression. They are the security officers. Some are assigned to carrying out the conversion of nectars into honey from the flower nectars brought into the hive by the foragers. Those are the corporate cooks manning the kitchen in the hive. Some engage permanently in fanning the interior of the hive with their tiny wings to reduce the heat and neutralize the humidity therein. Those are called ventilators. Some specialize in converting to propolis the resin of trees brought into the hive by the foragers. Those are called pharmacists or apothecarists. Some are assigned to the queen's special kitchen as special cooks, and they prepare royal jelly for the queen, which is the latter's exclusive food. Those are called the queen's royal chefs. Some are kept at the entrance of the hive for monitoring the environment and for passing any gathered information to the busy workers. Those are called informants. Some are put in charge of nursing the young bees into adults. They are called foster mothers. Some are assigned to the building and maintenance of the honeycomb. They are called colony architects and builders. Some are assigned to sterilizing the interior of the hive, sealing of any leakages therein, as well as to embalming any predators that stray into the hive after such predators might have been stung to death to prevent any outbreak of epidemic in the hive. Those are called sanitary inspectors. All of these duties are carried out by the female bees called worker bees. Scavenging officers. In the performance of their duties, some foragers do alert others about the discovery of sources of raw materials like nectar, pollen and resin in the visited vegetations by doing a waggle dance, which explains the direction and distance of those raw materials. If the source is within the range of 100 meters from the hive, the bees dance in a circular shape. If it is further away than 100 meters, they dance in figure 8 shape. Worker bees, by their nature, do travel very far in search of water or other raw materials needed to carry out their assigned duties in the hive. And they follow the principle of esprit de corps in carrying out such duties. This great division of labor is a daily routine which enables perfection to be attained in the hive. And all these activities are centrally coordinated by the queen bee from her palatial chamber. Features of drone bees. The drones are the male bees. They cannot sting because they are naturally not endowed to do that by virtue of the infertile eggs from which they are produced. Stinging is part of the duties of the worker bees. And each of them can sting only once in a lifetime. No bee can sting twice. That is why they move in groups when they are going to attack an object or an enemy. Stinging bees are like suicide bombers. They die in less than 30 minutes after they had stung. On the other hand, by virtue of the queen's position and the special food she eats, she can sting many times without any fear of death. It must be noted that the worker bees produce honey and other products for themselves and not for human consumption. Honey is the food of the bees. They work during the dry season and never in the rainy season because they cannot cope with the wind and storm which often accompany rains. Thus, during the rainy season, they concentrate on taking care of the queen and on nursing the younger bees. Therefore, the food which they had stored during the dry season is what they consume during the raining season. It takes an average worker bee about 21 days to grow into an adult from the egg status, while it takes the queen about 16 days to develop from the egg status to the royal status of a queen. For more research-based home remedies and natural health tips, subscribe to the channel. Follow us on Facebook at Natural Herb Cures and Twitter at Natural Herb Cure.